And now welcome to the United States Croquet Association AC National Championships in March of 2024. They're held at the recently renovated Sarasota County Croquet Club in Venice, Florida. The new courts are these three at the bottom of the screen. They have new shelters as well. It is a fabulous facility. Club president is Jim Colling, and tournament manager for this event is Nancy Hart. The aerial views are courtesy of Brian Hovis' drone, and Brian is the videographer for this event as well. Tournament director is Jeff Sue, with able assistance from his wife Eileen. And as always, we want to thank our sponsors, Chris Barley, the United States Croquet Association, under the guidance of President Damon Bidenkope, your source for all things croquet in all of its many versions, AC, American Rules, Golf Croquet, and Nine Wicket. And for all your equipment needs, be you beginner, world champion, or anybody in between, Don Oakley's Croquet Store. And now game two of the singles final. When they came in, it was Matthew, Zach, and Tom Balding, 1, 2, and 3 in the grades. They've both manhandled the field. Tom's edged into the lead and then took a bit more of a lead by winning game one. Chris Clark says that Robert Fletcher is a little uncomfortable with black being right there. Not quite as far as he put it, but I've never seen that done before. I use it in practice all the time because I don't have to walk very far. And what Zach's going to do usually happens in turn two. Danny Honeycutt has popularized this amongst the American players. Chris Clark doesn't like it, but Robert Fulford has used it. And actually, in turn three, I wonder if he wouldn't have been better off to shoot it black from the end of B ball into corner four, if possible. It may not be far enough out to allow that. And of course, he left a double from A ball. And Tom cashes in.
Stuck
I think it was at Mission Hills that Mike Todorovich first coached me to leave two balls together like that so I could use them when I came back for hoop three. And I thought, wait a minute, I'm leaving the opponent a really easy shot. But you can't let what you're leaving the opponent paralyze your offensive initiative. You got to go for it. Sometimes, anyway. That was the year that Mike Todorovich had the biggest increase in AC grade on record. I think he may have tied with somebody else. It was like 200 or 300 points or something. He's since become the victim of Mother Nature and regression to the mean, but he's the driving force behind teaching folks to play AC at the National Croquet Center. This early hoop six pioneer doesn't happen a lot. A lot of folks would have set black to five so they could drop off the early two back pioneer, but he's not concerned about that. He'll do a pivot swap or send the two black pioneer from six. I drop off an early pioneer at hoop six in my home court because it's a 3 foot drop from south to north, so it's an uphill split shot, taking black to five. Walt Janis, who's playing in first flight in this tournament, knows all about that. He and Sandy live in Indianapolis, except for the 3 or 4 months they live in Sarasota. We play on my court all the time. Thank you. I think he's gesticulating because yellow went farther than he wanted it to. It's not going to make any difference. But he may have been planning to do a mom standard leave. And then now he's going to go back to a diagonal spread. I keep harping on getting a rush out of three back. Well, this is how you do it. And look how much easier it makes finishing the diagonal spread. So Zach opened with a super shot. Tom put black in basically mirror position from the super shot. Zach dribbled at it, left a double, and Tom hit it. In turn five and made nine and laid a diagonal spread. And now a chance for the equalizing break. Maybe a TPO, or maybe a New Zealand TPO. One of these days, somebody's going to do one for me. It's a tactic to use against somebody who just can't miss. Can't think of a better time. What he would do is make six with yellow, and on the way, peel blue through four back. And he stops at one back, wiring blue and black from each other at hoop one. And then he parks red and yellow in corner three, as in the delayed sextuple lead. And then when Tom hopefully misses the tea lady, he goes around with red, peeling yellow through one back, two back, maybe three back, but definitely peeling blue through penult and rover, and then pegging out red and blue. And that would leave black on one and yellow on, say, three back. The thought being that you can beat anybody if you're that far ahead in a two-ball game. Someday. Matthew has promised he would do it, but we haven't seen it on video yet. The closest I've seen is Brian Cumming, who introduced it to me and some other players. Was it Sonoma Cutrera, I think, in 2016, probably? He was playing Ben Rothman, set it up against Ben, and then Ben hit the tea lady. Of course he did. Thank you. Zach may know why that happened, but it wasn't visible from here. Tom would, of course, prefer to play his hoop one ball black, but blue is right next to yellow's hoop, and it's sandwiched between red and yellow, so red can shoot at blue and join up with yellow if it misses. So he's got to get blue out of there. Shoots at red, then red and yellow get the innings back, so they shoot at black and see what happens. My favorite, the Wiley method. I want to thank Stuart Lawrence for clarifying for me that this is only really useful if the pili has either been jawsed or been peeled but not gathered and brought to penult by the time the striker ball makes hoop five. That's just the case here. And now he wants to roquet red and into something like peeling position, but not right in front of the hoop, because then he'll hit it when black makes hoop six. And that may be what happened. Let's see. So red's going to end up being the ball he uses to place the two-back pioneer and approach the pili in the same shot. And then yellow will be the one-back pioneer. We hope. Yep, it was on the approach line. Now, fortunately, he's done exactly the right thing with red. It's not down on the boundary. It's a couple, 3 yards off the yard line, which means that he can now peel blue and then turn around and roquet red and keep things going. This croquet shot's a real test of distance control. and he aced it. Because Black's rush on yellow to one back was the only part that really counted. Blue's not rushable, so he'll have to come back probably after three back again. Okay, last time I'll mention it, promise. The rush north out of three back is even more important when you're trying to get the penult peel done. And it looks like he's got it down. He is making it look stupid easy. He really is. While he's finishing up, give us a like, subscribe, hit the notification bell. I'm going to do one more game, a first flight contest between two people who are near and dear to me, Walt Janitz and Becky Essig. So as Ben Rothman says, it's just 168 easy shots. And Tom does make it look easy. The two top seeds made it to the final after running roughshod through the field. Tom wins it convincingly 2-0 to become the 2024 USCA AC National Champion. He was undefeated in 12 games, 10 of them triple peels, and he added a sextuple and a Zed game after he did this. They've rearranged the rankings. Tom is now the top-ranked player in the U.S. Everybody's pretty closely grouped, and this is more so you can see how to get to this site than anything else if you don't know. Rank.worldcroquet.org. This is where I'll get all the information about the AC rankings. Thanks, as always, to our sponsors, Chris Barley, the United States Croquet Association, your source for everything croquet, and Don Oakley's Croquet Store, providing the equipment needs of beginners, world champions, and everybody in between.